your smooth home drive. Dominate.
Okay, 14 minutes just right compared to 9 o'clock right here on Splash 105.5 FM. Your host for the most, Kolade's back on radio this amazing Thursday, okay? And I am excited that you are definitely on the flip side of radio. You know, at exactly 9 o'clock, we bring in your favorites live on radio so that you can get to learn one or two things about them, okay? I'm going to be talking to my brother, DJ Neptune, tonight, and he is on standby. How you doing, DJ Neptune?
Very well. How
are
you doing,
my brother? I'm fine. What's good? What's happening?
Man, lockdown, that's what's happening.
Everybody's at home.
Sleeping. Being on social media. I mean, there's pretty much nothing to do. Also monitoring the news around the world as well. So basically, I'm just chilling at home.
Okay.
That's it.
That's it. So I'm going to run through a lot of things now, because I know that in the early 2000s, you were ruling the radio airwaves with mixes in Lagos, Southwest Nigeria, basically. And then you can still hear a lot of DJ Neptune in town. And you've grown to become the most booked DJ in Nigeria. Anybody that does not know that should probably check that out. And you've played across, concerts in Nigeria and Africa. Now, tell me first, where did you get the name DJ Neptune from?
So the name DJ Neptune came from a record that was produced by the band Neptunes.
Okay.
That's Pharrell and his battle crew. So they produced a track for Busta Rhyme, and Busta Rhyme had given Neptunes a shout out. So early stage in my career, I was fond of doing a particular routine whereby I would scratch that part of the record.
Yeah.
And then few guys that have been to some of my parties.
Yeah.
Came to this particular party I was DJing, and they saw me again, and one of them just randomly said, this Neptune's guy is here again. And mind you, then this was 2 years into my career. I didn't really have a steady DJ name.
Okay.
I tried different kind of names, but it didn't sit in well. So when I heard that statement, I was like, someone already identifies me with something I love doing, so why not just stick to this? So I went home, did my research, made sure there was no other DJ across Nigeria, Africa that had that name. Took out the S and I ran away with it.
Wow, pretty amazing. So
Imagine
you got that name from a particular record, from a particular scratch routine. That's really crazy.
Yeah, thank you, man.
Okay, away from that one, how does it feel to have the number one song in the country? This is something like you've done back to back. Like each and every time you put out a record, it just goes straight to the top of the chart. Tell me, is there a particular formula? Is there something that you do that a lot of people don't do, a lot of people don't pay attention to? Tell me about that. How does it feel?
It feels good. It feels great. 7 weeks straight up in there, trending number one. Record, not just in Nigeria, across Africa.
Yeah.
I feel blessed. And there's really no formula to making music, but make sure the end result of what you're doing is good music, and it can sell itself and speak for itself.
Mm.
And that is one thing that nobody has, from the production to the featured artist to the delivery to the music video, everything was perfect, So when the song came out, I knew it was going to be a smash hit, but I didn't know people were going to love it this much. So I'm grateful. I thank God for the opportunity to be alive, because I'm literally living my dreams right now. I've always dreamt of having a number one record that would just be perfect.
Yeah.
And this song, it came out 6th of March, it's just been dumb crazy numbers. We're almost hitting 20 million across streaming platforms.
Mm-hmm.
Still trending number one. I mean, when you listen to the song, you get tired. When you come back to it again, it sounds fresh.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know. I think God's grace as well. So,
okay.
Biggest to anybody's streaming.
Obviously, I'm going to have to take you way back, because it feels like I need to talk about this particular one as well. This one that had M.I., Native C, and Da Green. That was another number one song.
that to me,
yeah.
I don't care what anybody says.
Yeah.
That is still one of the biggest collaboration when it comes to hip hop in Africa.
Yes, now. No disrespect. Let's give honor to whom honor is due to.
No disrespect. And that song was made 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And it still sounds, it still competes with today's hip hop reference. So that's a classic right there.
That's what I'm talking about.
Shout out to MI, shout out to the late Dagrin, whose 10th year anniversary was yesterday.
Yeah.
And May 6 years old. Big ups. And for MI for producing that record too. Yeah. MI producing, I mean, a lot of people didn't know that.
Wow. Yeah, major. I saw it on your Instagram page yesterday that he actually produced the song. I was like, wow. A lot of us didn't know that.
Yeah, I know. A lot of people didn't know. A lot of people didn't know.
Major. Okay, now let's talk about DJ across Africa. And we see that a lot of people, you know, run into the business right now. A lot of people want to be DJs and stuff. What do you think DJs across Nigeria need to know and understand to push their brand and their craft further?
I mean, they need to understand that there's power. They have the power to do whatever they want to do because, I mean, we have millions of DJs scattered across the country.
Mm-hmm.
And as an artist, if you want your song to move real fast, you need to mess with the DJ. It's just what it is. You can have radio, you can have TV, all that is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
But imagine you having millions of DJs spinning your record one night across the country.
Yeah.
Your music will move real, real fast. So as DJs, we need to understand the power we have. You need to understand your worth. Also, don't sell yourself cheap. Make sure your branding is right because you don't know who's looking at you, wants to put in some money on your brand, so you need to be on top of your game. And I mean, learn the basics. Know what DJing is all about. DJing is way beyond just playing records. There's a psychological part whereby, I mean, you're on radio. I mean, okay, now you're a presenter, you're a DJ, you're on radio.
Yeah.
You're not seeing me, the audience, at home or in a car, but you're playing my music. Now that's a psychological part, like in your head. You're hitting the people with the right song. You know, those are things you need to take, or rather put into consideration to be a good DJ. Because I see DJs, DJ, and they just play for themselves. And
yeah.
The crowd is just going, like, what's this guy playing? What's she playing?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so those are the things you need to understand about the business. Yeah, I mean, it's lucrative right now. Like, for me, when I started, it was the passion. There was no money.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, along the line, money started coming in, and then I understood that, okay, for more money to come in, I need to start doing the right things, you know? So, but now, it's just to everybody trying to be a DJ, maybe some for the paparazzi, for the razzmatazz, some to make money, but whatever it is, just stay true to the game.
Now, some people are of the opinion that when a DJ features an artist on a song, the DJ does nothing. You're apparently one of the most featured DJs in the country.
I mean, I think everybody wants a spice of that greatness.
Yeah.
Everybody wants a spice. Yeah, that's just what it is. But I mean, big ups to everybody that wants to. Those are still going to work. And I mean, I'm just steady working, to be honest.
Okay.
Whoever wants to work with me, if the vibe is right, the music has to be good. I'm down. That's it. Now, the thing is that, one, there's no rule to making music.
Yeah.
Two, as a DJ, if you know you have what it takes to start tuning out your own records, go for it. But if you don't and you feel, oh, this is what A is doing, then let me copy what A is doing, and then you don't now do it right, that is where it seems awkward. For me, I take part in the production.
Okay.
I take part in the direction of my music. Most times I come up with a concept. You know, it might not end up being what it is.
Mm-hmm.
But I have an imprint in everything I do. I'll give you an example.
Okay.
10 years ago, I really wanted to remix with MI and Lucas and Nadine.
Yeah.
These rappers were thinking towards that direction of working with each other when I did that collaboration.
Mm-hmm.
And shortly after that, my brain unfortunately passed on. So if we didn't actually make that record happen, there probably would have been a record with MI, Lucas and Nadine.
True be told.
You know, so that it is what it is. It is what it is.
Amazing.
People just need to open their mind because I mean, I've been seeing people that what are they even doing? They'll just come, they'll just shout. Nah, it's way beyond that. But, I mean, it's a gradual process.
Yeah.
You know, they say the only constant in life is change. So,
obviously,
people are adapting to it. They are getting to understand, okay, these guys are superstars themselves. They're not just guys behind the decks.
Mm-hmm.
They can actually do it. That's for the guys, the DJs that can put out records. So,
brilliant.
Big ups to everyone doing this.
Okay, lovely, though. Now, I want to go into a little bit of private talk. You know, you've got a family now. You've got a wife. You've got, you know, an amazing, amazing child. But I want to go into that. How are you able to blend both family, spending a lot of nights out there because of your job, and paying attention to the basic needs of the family? You know, sometimes when you look at it, as a man, you have to be there. You have to be there. You have to play an active role in your child's life. You have to play an active role in the family. How are you able to put everything together?
I mean, I won't lie to you, it's crazy, you know, considering the amount of bookings I get. Almost like weekends, I'm barely at home.
Yeah.
Weekdays, I'm doing weekends. I'm doing my radio show. You know, well, I mean, my family understands, okay, this is what this one does. This is what puts food on the table.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so business has to be taken care of regardless. I mean, if I was a doctor, obviously, I would wake up early in the morning and go to the hospital to
look after
patients. You know, so this is my job. You know, most times I'm out at night, but I'm not working during the day. I'm at home, you know, and my peers who are working as other professionals, they are in their office at that time of the day.
Yeah.
So it is what it is. This is what I do. I'm an entertainer. But then I try as much as possible to strike the balance. Like, so when I'm not working, I try to spend more time with my family, my daughter as well. And then when it's time to hit the road, they understand, okay, this man has to go hustle.
Okay, that's pretty good, and everybody understands. Have you been in any position that you're just like heading out of the house, and then your daughter just pulls you back and says, "Daddy, you're not going to door. Let me go with you."
That happens a lot. Most of the time, I always have to shake her. I have to shake her. Okay, let me get something. I just put my mouth.
Let's go together.
Yeah, that happens all the time.
Okay, pretty amazing. Then let's talk about the female fans now. It's crazy when, you know, DJ Neptune pulls up at your party and then is playing, giving you great music back and forth. Now, tell me, have you been able to handle those overzealous female fans? Looking at the fact that most of these ladies, you know what they can do. You know the extent that they can go to.
I mean, I understand where you're coming at. I mean, the truth is, it is what it is. As a celebrity in general, if you're a female celebrity, obviously your fans, most of them would probably be the opposite sex.
Yeah.
You know, and same thing for a male celebrity. But now, what you need to understand is there has to be like a fence, or rather, there has to be a gauge. Like, listen, yeah, you appreciate me for what I do. Let it stay like that. Be on the other side. I'm on this other side. I'm not going to cross over, and you don't even try to cross over. So for me, I try to create that mutual respect. Okay, I appreciate you guys for loving me for what I do. Putting smiles on your face. You know, but it is what it is.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Know how to draw the line each and every time. Okay, so let's take a look at the projects for 2020. Nobody's out there doing great with Mr. Easy and Joe Boy. Pretty amazing song. What else do we have in stock? What else are you coming out with? What else are you doing for 2020? What else should we watch out for?
Funny enough, after the release of Nobody, I was meant to put out a track list for the next body of work I'm currently working on.
Okay.
Unfortunately, this whole pandemic came into play, and then I have to push that back a little bit. So there is an album dropping, my sophomore album, dropping very soon.
Yeah, sophomore album coming.
That's coming very soon. I have other plans. I have other plans to do a uni tour, do a club tour, and then obviously my Sound of Neptune concert this year. But with what is going through right now, I don't know how all that will play out.
Okay.
Fingers crossed. Let's see how that goes. But for now, I'm just focused on the music. I put out Nobody. That's doing well. I'm working on something that still surrounds Nobody.
Okay.
I will reveal that no matter what.
Okay.
And then I would watch the situation and decide with the team if we still want to go ahead and put out the album or just hold on and see what's happening around the world.
Okay. So apparently what you're telling us is something about Nobody is also coming out pretty soon.
Fingers crossed.
Okay. You don't want to give me exclusive.
Don't worry. Right, obviously, right before it comes out, I'll highlight you so you still get me.
All right, no problem. So this year there might be a sophomore album. That's what you're saying.
No, there will be definitely, because the honest truth is I'm 85% done with the project.
Okay.
Yeah, like I said, I was meant to release the track list
around
this time, but with what's happening around the world, there's so much focus on that. So I'm pulling back and they're still promoting Nobody, which is obviously still doing well, so yeah.
Okay, no problem. Thank you so much, DJ Neptune, for coming through.
Thanks for your time, man. I appreciate you.
Yeah, bless up. Much love all the way, and much love to the family.
Thank you so much. Shout out to everybody streaming my music.
Yeah.
God bless you guys. Appreciate you.
Where can I find you on social media, just in case people are listening to you right now, and they're like, I want to stalk DJ Neptune. What's going on?
Yes, please. I'm bored. Come and discover my social. It's at DWEJAY Neptune on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook. Snapchat is DJ Neptune TV. So just follow me, I'll follow back, and the rest is mine.
Okay, no problem. Big shout out to you, DJ Neptune. Much regards to the family. What song should we drop right now? I started the show with 1, 2, 3, okay? And I went to, I played another song, which was this great tune that I love. Baddest. I played Baddest.
Yeah,
I love Baddest.
Yeah, I heard that.
Okay, which one should I drop right now?
Let's do Nobody. That's the one everybody.
Okay. Let's do Nobody. Right after Nobody, you should listen to Wait from DJ Neptune and Kiss Daniel, okay?
Yep.
All right, no problem. God bless. Thank you so much for coming through. Okay, that was DJ Neptune, and I hope you enjoyed yourself in the spotlight. Yes, major stuff about him. Exclusives, though, a sophomore album dropping this year. Depends on COVID-19. And of course, Unitour, Sounds of Neptune concert in Lagos as well. A couple of other great things happening. All right, these guys are working, and definitely I'm bringing the exclusives to you. Don't also forget that he said that something around Nobody's going to be dropping. I sense it's going to be a mixtape. It's going to be new music. Fingers crossed. Okay, let's go play You Nobody by DJ Neptune featuring Joe Boy and Mr. Easy. Right after that one, you listen to another song. And this one, there's a song from DJ Neptune and Kiss Daniel, it's titled Wait. Enjoy.